there are over 200 neurotransmitters and hormones in your body that control your metabolism. So we can make changes in our lifestyle to improve the function of all of these 200 neurotransmitters. So they will work for you in helping you lose weight and maintain weight. When you lose weight by following a very low calorie diet, you end up messing up your metabolism, so when you go back to eating normal, you gain more weight than you had to begin with. I tell my patients that there's no such thing as a magic diet that will make you lose fast and easy. There is no such thing. And also, very low calorie diets, crash diets, or fad diets, none of those things work well. What works for weight loss is a series of lifestyle changes, which include not just diet, but diet, physical activity, stress management, better sleep, and most importantly, your relationship to food. I like to think that if you are always negative about weight loss, you never lose weight for good, because you're always being deprived. And when you're deprived, then your brain resets itself to crave things that you're not supposed to have. So we'd like to change that. We'd like to reverse that. We'd like to have you think of not being on a diet at all, and not thinking of yourself as being overweight, thinking of yourself in a positive way. And when you're thinking of yourself in a good way, that I'm so healthy and I look so awesome, then you don't want to put bad stuff in your body, right? It's hard to discipline yourself. It takes 40 days to make a new habit, right? So we do use things to help you along. We use appetite suppressant, which helps you control cravings. We use some supplements, which are not magical supplements, but they're supplements that are meant to improve your metabolism. We also use HCG if you don't have any contraindications to that. Remember that none of these things by themselves will make you lose weight. These things only help you stay on the program, which is what will make you lose weight. You should not be looking at the number on the scale. I think you should be more focused on adopting a healthy lifestyle and how to maintain that. When you have this new self-esteem, new way of thinking, a new lifestyle, then you are much more likely to follow a lifestyle that you've learned and maintain your weight.